baseball fans, and welcome. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Baltimore Orioles taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. And Singy, there's been a lot to talk about already in this series as we head into game four.
And I'll be interested to see if these teams approach it any differently, with one on the brink of elimination and the other just a win away from putting an end to this thing. You know, in the postseason, I think you have to treat every game the same, but there's something about an elimination game that can put a team just into a different mindset.
Yeah, and the strategy could certainly change in this type of game. It's hard to manage the same way when in any given at bat, it can impact everything you've been working for throughout the season. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go. Our starting pitcher in this one, Drew Rasmussen.
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel, and that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
Cedric Mullins, the leadoff batter, as he looks at ball one. That one missing inside.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
The 2-1. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there, and I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in, kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to where you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it, and not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
And it's 1-1. Fly ball down the line. Squeezes it. Two up, two down. Time now to take a look at the Orioles lineup put together by manager Brandon Hyde. Chris, this is a lineup offensively that could be really good for years to come.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team, and I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
And he deals. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Orioles held in check there, and now the Rays will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. And we're back. And on the hill, the big righty, Grayson Rodriguez.
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way, because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
Josh Lowe in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Now this is in the air down the line. And a foul ball. And here it comes. Ripped to third and caught. Now a look at Kevin Cash's lineup for the Tampa Bay Rays. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds, because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
That one finds the zone. That's strike two.
Kelly left that changeup up. Got away with one there, and he'll take it, but doesn't want to make that mistake again.
Off the mark there, and that is ball one. One down, base is empty. And down on strikes he goes. Out number two.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball. Two outs, base is empty. The next offering misses. Gonna count one and two.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, to look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase.
Now that's strike three and the third out. So we take a break. Nothing in the Tampa first. On to the second now for Tropicana. Still back now in Tampa Bay. Top of the second. Anthony Santander at the plate.
One wonderful thing about the postseason, you never know who's going to be the hero. It could be the superstar, but often it's a far more unlikely player.
And that's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single. And next for the Orioles, Gunnar Henderson. Almost got him. You know, one unlikely postseason hero I saw up close, Alex Gonzalez of the Marlins in the 2003 World Series. Wasn't really known for his bat, but he hit a walk-off homer in extra innings in Game 4. It tied the series and was a huge momentum swing.
Two consecutive base hits for this team. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Ramon Urias in the box now. Take strike one. And that one fouled off. The pitch.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Good job to fight that one off. Here's the 0-2. Got him looking for the K.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Here's Ryan Mountcastle. In there at the knees. And that's strike one.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
That clips the inside corner for a strike. Patrick Johnson behind the plate.
Patty Johnson to Sunberg, but I'd ask permission first before I call the man. Does a pretty good job back there. Occasionally we'll see a couple of sideways looks from players, but that kind of comes with the territory, right?
Now this is through for a base hit. Here comes the runner. Here comes the throw. He scores and they have the lead. 1-0.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Ryan O'Hearn, the next to hit, takes ball one. Left-hand hitter waits. On the ground, could be two. There's one to Diaz. That's two. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 1-0. This is the American League Division Series on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom half of inning number two. Now here's the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Brandon Lau. There's a strike. Lau, 29 years old, and he's won a silver slugger in the American League. That one is absolutely belted. In one hops off the wall, should be extra bases. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Just a solid swing right there. Got it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
And stepping in for the Rays, Christopher Morel. That one finds the zone. That's strike one.
Well, the best way to shake off yesterday's struggles is to get on the board early. They've got a guy in scoring position. They've got to find a way here to get him in.
That one ripped. Mullins on his horse. And in one hops the wall. The run comes in from second. It's 1-1. And he's got himself a triple.
Well, we're starting over again, all tied up. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
This is Dylan Carlson. And there's the strike. One on, nobody out, a run in here in game four of this ALDS. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Drops into the glove. Runner tags from third. Applies the tag, and they get two. Double play.
Such an impressive play defensively right there. The outfielder on the run first makes the catch, but then quickly able to set his feet and get a strong enough throw with accuracy to the dish. Nice job by the catcher as well to finish it off. Just a highlight play.
Jose Siri stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Smoked on the ground a second. Whips it to Mountcastle. That's out number three. Rays with an RBI triple. All even at one apiece. And we're back. New inning getting started. Here's the second baseman, Jackson Holliday. And a pitch. Right down the chute, strike one.
Goodness, I think he just took the best pitch he's going to see in this at bat. You don't get many like that in that location. I don't know if you take that pitch against any pitcher out there on the mound.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. So the lineup flips over. So next to hit for Baltimore, Cedric Mullins. Swinging a foul straight back. One down, base is empty. Headed down the line. And that drops foul. Tied up here in the early going. On the ground to first, Diaz. He steps on the bag. And that quickly, two away.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
And now it's Austin Hayes. He's 0 for 1. And that's in for a strike. And a swing and a miss.
Well, you got the hitter already chasing that nasty slider. If you're on the mound, you just want to expand the zone right now. Get a swing and miss and get through this at bat.
Diaz takes it to the bag, and the Orioles set down in order. Nothing doing here this half. We head down to the home half of inning number three. All tied 1-1. Back here at Tropicana Field, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Ben Wortvedt. Rodriguez back to work. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Hawaii to kick the pitch. This one smacked out to left center. Could be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. The throw in, but he's in there easily.
put a pretty good jolt into that one. Great swing, nice balance and weight transfer, and he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field.
Taylor Walls, next to hit for the Rays. Right through there for a strike. Runner in scoring position, nobody out here in game four. And that's in the dirt. Line drive and out number one on the grab.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
Back to the top of the lineup. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Josh Lowe. That one ripped, but foul. Kick, Sandios. Next offering is outside. One out and a runner at second. The 1-1 is fouled off. Man at second. Laced down the line. Could be extra bases. And that rolls into the corner. Runner from second crosses the plate. It's 2-1.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left.
Man at second with one away. Now the number two hitter, Junior Caminero. Right through there for a strike. Not close with that one. And the count even 1-1. And a pop-up right side, foul territory. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. And a ball and two strikes.
Oh,
and another ball. Just missed.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
Yandy Diaz now. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. Just missed. Swing and a base hit. Coming home. Here's the throw to the plate. And he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning.
Well, it's pretty difficult to throw a base runner out at the plate with two outs and a base hit to the outfield, but an excellent job of coming up with it, getting rid of it quickly, and throwing on the money. That is great technique from start to finish.
Game four of the division series. Here's Adley Rutschman. That one's in there, and it's 0-1.
0-1.
Line drive, Adam in center field.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Santander in now, takes ball one off the plate. The pitch. And a foul ball. Base is empty, one away. Top half of inning number four. And a swing and a miss. And there's two away.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Now it's going to be Gunnar Henderson.
Going one. All one's the count.
Two down, nobody on. As the Rays try and punch back down a run. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Urias in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple.
And down on strikes. And that is that. And the Orioles lead one. And our score remains 2-1. Back now in Tampa Bay, John Chami and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Brandon Lau. The wind of the pitch. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. And that skips in the dirt. And the right-hander deals. That one finds the zone. And a count 1-2. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down.
The batter number 24, second baseman
Christopher Morel will hit next. Morel. It was a triple and an RBI at his first at bat. That clips the zone. Strike one.
Now just a cement mixer slider right there. It's a great pitch to hit if you can recognize it early and jump on it.
Swing and a miss. Looked off balance that time. One out. Base is empty. The punch out there. And there are two outs.
Well, he locked him up with the cutter on the outside right there, and I got to think he was looking middle in because he just couldn't pull the trigger. And, you know, with two strikes, fastball coming in, you've got to be ready to swing it. That time it cut to the outside part of the plate, and he just couldn't pull the trigger.
Now batting.
So two down, now up for Tampa Bay, Jose Siri. Swing and a miss. And that is strike one. Carlson off of first with two away. There's a swing and a drive. This one's got a chance. Pulls it in on the warning track. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. We played four. It's the Rays 2 and the Orioles 1. We go to the top of the fifth and into the box for Baltimore. Ryan Mountcastle. Right through there for a strike. Mountcastle measures 6 feet 4 inches. 27 years old. A former first round pick back in 2015. 0-2 now. Got him swinging.
That was a well-executed slider away for the strikeout right there. First two pitches filled up the zone and got him ahead 0-2 in the count. And at that point, he can start expanding the zone as a pitcher. He made a chase and got the quick strikeout.
Ryan O'Hearn comes up to hit. Wouldn't chase that time. Oh. splits the plate, and it's 1-1. On the ground to third. Over to Diaz. And a couple of quick outs.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
Now it's the second baseman, Jackson Holliday. Ball one there. The Orioles trailing by a run. And we're at the top of the fifth. Swing and a miss. And it's a ball and a strike. On the ground. Gathers and throws to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. So they make short work of them there. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Rays 2 and the We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now the catcher for the Rays, Ben Wortvedt. The right-hander back to work. Just missed.
Well, these Rays, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. We've already seen 8 line drives from them, and it's always a good sign when the ball is jumping off your bat. And that's what this offense has been doing so far today.
Mountcastle steps on the bag, and the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. Taylor Walls, next to hit for the Rays. He's 0-1. First pitch, and he just misses. The shortstop takes a ball.
2-0.
That one finds the zone. Strike one.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
In the air, left side. Hayes pulls that one down, 2 away.
The right fielder, number 15.
Digging in, Josh Lowe, 1-for-2. And a base hit right there. And that keeps the inning going.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
That one fouled off. Low off of first with 2 away. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And gone. That'll fire up the dugout, and they tack on to their lead. It's 4-1.
Already playing with the lead, and now they're celebrating a home run. They're having a great time out there. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Base is empty with 2 away. And stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. In for a strike. It's 0-1. In the air, out towards left center. Mullins makes the play, and it's out number 3. But 2 come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this 2-run homer. It's now a 4-1 ball game. All set for the top of the 6th. And now the center fielder, Cedric Mullins. Rasmussen back to work. Curveball over for a called strike.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And a pitch. In the air, right field. Low, ranging after it. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
The batter. The left fielder, Austin Hayes.
Austin Hayes, the next to hit for the Orioles. Swings through that one for strike one.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
That one ripped. Bangs off the wall. Around first and hustling for second. Carlson with a quick throw back in. And they hold him at second. Maybe this is going to be the moment they start the comeback.
Now batter, Ashley Rutherford.
Adley Rutschman now at the plate. Right through there for a strike.
0-1.
O-1 gets a check swing. Appeal to third. And he won around. Rule the swing. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Well, that was the cutter down and in right there. And typically, if you're going to have a chance with the pitch, if it's down, that's your best chance of doing anything with it. It's kind of like a mini slider, just with a little less vertical movement. But still, that one tied him up, and he couldn't get the barrel to it.
Santander stands in now and watches strike one. The Rays leading by three, and we're the top half of the sixth. And the pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. And that should be extra bases. Hayes coming around third. He's in safely at second. And a run comes in to score.
Picks himself up at RBI. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you can tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
And it's scoring position with two away. And here is Gunnar Henderson. And that one clips the corner. Now this one's crushed down the line. Hooking. Foul ball. On the ground, right side. Diaz takes it himself. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. The O's add one on an RBI double. It's now 4-2. Coming on for the Orioles, Dylan Tate.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Dylan Tate.
Lau at the plate.
For the Rays. The designated hitter, Brandon.
The wind and the pitch. Missed with a changeup. Ball one.
No
activity
strike
in the bullpen. Cionel Perez is up and throwing for Brandon Hyde. Cologne also getting ready. Kicks and fires. Right through there for a strike.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. The other way, and he beats the shift. And the leadoff man aboard.
Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Christopher Morel. Right side. Santander in pursuit. Makes the catch for the out. And there's one away. Dylan Carlson next to hit for the Rays. Fastball for a strike, and it's 0-1.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And a pitch. dives, and he can't hang on. Still able to get it there in time. And they come away with an out after a tricky start to the play.
This is what it's all about on that right side of the diamond when you've got the first baseman involved and the pitcher as well. First baseman does a great job, knocks the ball down, gets away from a little bit, doesn't panic. The pitcher's exactly where he's supposed to be. Nice feed and a nice play for the out.
Siri up for the third time here. Watches that one miss. Got the bat going too soon and strike two.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Got him. Inning over on the strikeout. So one hit is all they get. Game four heads to the seventh inning now. It's the Rays 4 and the Orioles 2. Javier Assad on a pitch here.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So digging in, Ramon Urias. Edge of the zone for a strike. 1-1.
Well, now that this is a bullpen game, it's clear that whichever bullpen steps up the most is likely going to come away with the W.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And a pop-up. Right side, foul territory. And that will drop foul. And the righty deals. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at-bat. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch-out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And the batter now, Ryan Mountcastle. Fouled off. He was late. The Rays trying to protect a two-run lead late here in game four. That one finds the zone, and that is strike two. This one popped up, middle of the infield. Morrell has a beat on it, calls it in, and there's two away.
Now batting.
So two down now, and here is Ryan O'Hearn. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Caminero drifts towards it, and that is that. Three up, three down for the Orioles. They trail it here, 4-2. Left-hander out of the bullpen, Danny Coulon.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
And leading off,
now up for Tampa Bay, Ben Wortvedt. As the lefty gets to work. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
0-1.
Swings through that one.
0-2.
Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
No batter, number six.
Taylor Walls. Next to hit for the Rays. And that one pulled foul. Runner at first with no outs here. In the dirt. No advance. Good job behind the dish. Here comes a pitch. Foul ball. It stays 0-2. At the belt and fires. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Nobody out. Runner at first. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Now batting. Right.
So the Rays batting order turns over. Josh Lowe next to hit for the Rays. And that one is inside ball one. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch you could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
The third baseman, number 13, Junior Caminero.
That's the outside corner with that one.
Really good job in this spot to get ahead in the count. He's going to have to continue, finish off this hitter.
Two on, one out. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's the second out.
The first baseman,
Yandy Diaz. Next to hit for the Rays.
Diaz.
One for three. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. One run is in. Now two runs score, and they lead by four.
Nicely done. Brings home two. When you see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the end?
So they turn to the lefty in this spot, Cionel Perez.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And now it's Brandon Lau. And that's through there for a strike.
All ones account.
And now the lefty. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Mullins hauls it in to end the inning. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. It's now 6-2. Here's the second baseman, Jackson Holliday.
The second baseman.
As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers. Sinker gets the bottom of the zone, and that's a strike. Assad goes 6'1", 200 pounds, and he's a native of Mexico. Foul ball still 0-2. Right-handed reliever. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The wind of the pitch. Out to short. Walls. Tosses to first. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. So back to the top of the Orioles lineup. Here's the center fielder, Cedric Mullins. That clips the corner.
0-1.
This one smoked out to left. And there are two down.
Now back, left fielder, Austin.
Now the left fielder, Austin Hayes.
Drove it off the wall last time, just missed out on a home run.
Now a fly ball to right center. Siri tracks it down for the out. Offense held in check there. Home half of inning number 8 straight ahead. It's the Rays 6 and the Orioles 2. So they turn to Craig Kimbrel.
Number 46, Craig Kimbrel.
Now it's the second baseman, Christopher Morel.
The second baseman, Christopher Morel.
The pitch. There's a strike. And that one hit 97 on the gun.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole. He's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake.
The 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
Just blown away in that at bat. 3 fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter, other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
In the air to left down the line. And a foul ball. Bases empty, one away. Here the bottom half of the 8th inning. High fly ball out to left field. And there's 2 down.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the center fielder.
2 outs, bases empty. And now it's Jose Siri. 0-for-3, a fly out, a ground out, and a strikeout. Late on that fastball.
Just a bit tardy there. Not sure if he had a hard time picking it up out of the hand or if he was sitting off speed.
Swings through that.
0-2.
Gets a piece, and it stays 0-2.
Yeah, with 2 strikes here, you really want to miss outside the zone with that breaking ball.
And he deals. Fights it off, you'll see another. Not even close there. And that's ball 1. Hard ground ball, base knock. And that keeps the inning alive.
Now I'm sure he feels really good about that one. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
And now, Ben Wortvedt popped up. Holiday settles underneath it and makes the grab. That is the inning. 1 left for Tampa. They lead it 6-2. And now the switch hitting catcher, Adley Rutschman. And this is a guy that doesn't just impact the game defensively. They count on him to deliver offense.
He's the first guy at the ballpark. He's got to study opposing hitters. He's got to get familiar with his starting pitcher for that night. And he's getting in the cage to take his swings. That's a whole lot, and so many times goes unnoticed.
And here comes. Stays alive. On the ground, right side, Morel. Fires over to first. Now 1 gone in the ninth. Anthony Santander, the next to hit for the Orioles. Hits the corner. 0-1. The Rays leading by 4 here at the top of the ninth. That one pushed foul out of play off to the left. Foul ball. It stays 0-2. And a pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2.
Well, having such a tough time putting him away. Six foul balls in a row. Man, what a battle.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. One down, base is empty. Oof! That one went straight back and got our ump right in the mask. Let's hope he's okay. Grinding AB right here. About to see pitch number 10. And that one missing low.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
And a 1-2. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Carlson pulls it down and there's two gone.
The batter, number two.
Orioles down to their final out. Gunnar Henderson digs in now. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. One strike away. Gets a piece and it stays 0-2. And that one hammered. Siri going back on it. And that is the ball game.
This team played extremely well to force this series into a game five. It's just like the game seven. You win or go home. That game five should be a lot of fun to watch.
And your final 6-2 for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the big